Hi, I'm David Adams. I'm your instructor for the Project Management course. In today's lecture, we'll cover how to develop a work breakdown structure. This is the first part of planning your project phase. In the last unit, we covered developing a project charter, which will help us develop the work breakdown structure. We will need to learn how to capture 100% of the work required. Come with me to learn how to develop a work breakdown structure. In the Unit 3 lecture, we'll start to talk about plan the project phase. We'll dive into what is a work breakdown structure. We'll learn how to create a WBS, and we'll look at the Bolt Delivery App project as an example. And we'll finalize with best practices. In the plan the project phase, a project manager will spend over 90% of his or her time. It will take the 9 lecture units to complete the plan the project phase. In Unit 3, we will be focusing on work breakdown structure. These are some of the precursors for the ultimate deliverable, which is the project plan and the project baseline. A work breakdown structure sort of looks like an organization chart. You start at the very top, a project like Paint Your Room. You start to break it into smaller segments, like initiating, planning, executing, controlling, and closing. And each of these major components are also broken down further. For example, with executing, you may have purchases, ready room, paint walls, paint trim, dry, and then restore. And for each of these, you may even break this down further. For instance, ready room may be including removing furniture, covering the carpet, and protecting the ceiling. And you may even proceed to break this down even further. How far should you go? Well, when it becomes a workable unit, and typically they recommend something like an 8-hour unit. So now, let us start working on the work breakdown structure for our in-class case study, the Bolt Delivery App project. We're going to grab the project charter and look at the deliverables. These deliverables will form the first level of our work breakdown structure, and they are project management, new product development, product creation, marketing, and commercialization. In putting together a work breakdown structure, I go old school. I like hanging things on the wall and seeing and moving things around. I get a large piece of brown paper, usually 3 feet by 10 feet. I get stickies and I get markers. And the stickies will be various colors so I can differentiate those in the work breakdown structure. As you can see from the lecture slide, I started my work breakdown structure with a blue sticky that named the project name itself, the Bolt Delivery App project. I then proceeded with adding the deliverables using yellow stickies and placed it underneath the project name. In a team environment, we added further work breakdown by adding stickies that were in yellow below each of the deliverables. With my history, I've had some work breakdown structure charts that had over 100 stickies to represent the full work that was required. This is a simpler case study, so under project management, there's a host of project activities, which I'll explain further. Under new product development, there's new product strategy, idea generation, and screening. Under product creation, concept testing, business analysis, and product development. Under marketing, market testing. And under commercialization, promotion and advertisement. You can see from the explosion of the project activities, we have 11 additional items that we'll be doing during this course. With a medium type project, it may take a few hours to complete it to capture all the tasks required to do 100% of the work. In the best case scenario, it's best to leave this work breakdown structure paper copy hanging for several days, because you'll add, change, move slides around until you're all satisfied that you captured everything you think you need to do to complete this project to meet the expectations. Once the work breakdown structure has been reviewed to satisfaction, it's best to transfer this to some sort of drawing program, and I like Google Drawings. This provides an excellent record for your project. A copy of this chart is located in Support Material Unit 3 in your D2L. So we now completed the first part in planning the project. By developing a work breakdown structure, it allows us to know what tasks are required to do the job. It's best done in person by a full team. Use lots of space, combine brown paper and stickies as required. Leave it up in the wall a few days, revisit it, and find refinements to make sure you got it right. Until next time. Thank you.